Yeah, obviously, if you look at priority, and we leaked in far too many goals in the first round, obviously the first step that we need to improve on is the defense. No point improving the attack and still not having a good defense. The team is always built from a strong defense, which unfortunately, because of some reasons as well, we did not achieve the targets in the first round. But now the second round, you see there's a different composure, different mentality in the team. What we have to sharpen, of course, it is the efficiency in front of the goal. We play good in terms of attack, but the last final moments in front of the goal, we're still shortcoming. There's no coolness yet, so we can give that final delivery and put in the ball a little bit more easy than what we're doing now. And that we're working on, of course. Okay, first of all, in football, there is always pressure. There's pressure on every player that enters the field, the players outside the field. And without pressure, the game is not to its best. So pressure is a part of the game. And good footballers, they live with pressure and they become better from it. And I see that the team is getting used to living a bit under pressure. And they're motivated to show that the results are getting better now. So that's part of the game. Pressure makes the game beautiful. But it is healthy pressure. Yeah, it must be pressure that we respect each other. It must be pressure that the supporters are always behind the team, because that is what they want to see. The players want to feel, they want to be at their best. And that is what we're working for. So pressure is good for the game. And of course we are highly motivated to win at home tomorrow, with a relatively new lineup in principle, with a change of foreigners, and that is very positive. Must not forget that in the league, in the last round, people only look at results, but people that understand football, they look at the circumstances and the factors that are involved in the matches. We played more or less with one or two foreigners only in the last four or five matches of the League One. Only the last match after the window transfer, we could already transform the team, and you could see there was a fast improvement of how the team plays together.
Persiapan sampai saat ini lebih ke recovery satu hari ini, karena memang jarak pertandingan sangat dekat, tapi sejauh ini insya Allah persiapan kita sangat baik sekali, dan berharap nanti melawan Padang kita bisa memberikan yang terbaik, bisa mendapatkan poin penuh di kandang kita sini, dan kita bisa mencoba untuk mendapatkan poin tersebut. Bukan persoalan yang mudah. Jangan kita lihat posisi Padang saat ini, tapi mereka banyak perubahan pemain, mereka banyak pergantian pemain, dan mereka pasti punya semangat baru menatapi putaran kedua ini tentunya. Dan posisi tidak menentukan kuat atau tidak kuatnya tim itu. Jadi jangan pernah anggap remeh siapapun lawan kita. Bagi kita tiap pertandingan sangat penting. Ya kita tahu semua. Kita tahu semua tugas kita di lapangan seperti apa. Ya, kita tahu tiap pertandingan di home itu sangatlah penting saat ini untuk kita, tim Persib. Jadi harus beritikad, bertekad untuk memberikan terbaik dulu. Hasil insya Allah akan datang dengan sendirinya.
I'm really sorry to say, I'm really hugely disappointed, because this is a process, of course, beyond anyone's control, that has taken too long time. And don't ask, people ask me the reason. I don't know the reason. I cannot answer. I only can stand up for Fabiano as a professional. He's been top class with the team. his quality is really needed in the team. That is why he come to Persib for, and we miss him already the first half of the season, which is a huge loss for Persib. I hope people really understand that the club is signing a player, but he cannot play for the team. And then we had good hopes that there was enough time to get him ready for the second round. Even that did not work. But for Fabiano to keep his spirit so high that he's training with us every day, to be so professional on the training, I feel so sorry for him, because as a player he wants to play and he's not allowed to play now. If he knew this earlier, we could have made maybe different arrangements. But the fact is he will wait now for his passport, for his neutralization. Now we can't do anything more than wait and wait and wait. And then if Fabiano is like up to it and he really feels motivated to play for Persib next season, I will welcome him with open arms, because he has shown his quality as a person and he's shown his quality as a player as well. So it's only with a big disappointment that I can say that he cannot play for Persib this season.